Hey everybody, it's Kevin, and today we're going to take a closer look at the new features in Premiere Pro CC 12.1. There are a good number of improvements to the Essential Graphics panel that you should be aware of. The first of which is the new search-based browser for the Essential Graphics panel. Switch to the Graphics workspace to check out the new functionality of the Essential Graphics panel. Click the Browse tab to see that the panel has been redesigned for better searching, animated previews, along with tagging and favoriting in order to manage your motion graphics templates more easily. There is a search bar here that you can use to enter any search terms to find the template you need. The view will refresh with templates that you are searching for. Favorite a motion graphics template by clicking the star icon underneath the thumbnail of the template. Click on the star icon next to the search bar to filter for favorite motion graphics templates. You can click the checkboxes for either your local installed templates or CC libraries to target a specific location or to narrow your search. By clicking the small icon underneath any motion graphics template, you can view a larger preview of the animation, rename the template, view info about such things as fonts used, or to add or remove keywords to the template. Animation in the Essential Graphics panel. You can now animate graphics inside the Essential Graphics panel. Here's how. With your graphics selected, place the playhead where you want to begin the effect. Enable any of the transform effects in the panel by clicking on its parameter. You can see the effect is selected because the parameter appears as blue. Change the value at this point if you like. Then, move the playhead. Change the value or move the wireframe to add a second keyframe and so forth. Your effect is now done. This works great for quickly roughing in animations for text and graphics. The creation of gradients for shapes is now available in the Essential Graphics panel. To get started, first create the shape and then click the fill icon. The color picker launches. In the color picker, you can click the menu and choose to create either a linear or a radial gradient. You can add or adjust color and opacity stops as you like. Click OK once you are satisfied with the gradient. There is also a direct manipulation line to adjust gradients in a more visual fashion. Just click the selection tool to access the direct manipulation line. Drop shadow size in the Essential Graphics panel. Drop shadow size now appears with the other drop shadow parameters when a drop shadow is enabled for text or graphic shapes. So those are the new features. Thank you so much for watching. Hey guys, we love making these videos and we can't wait to make even more. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, or even better, subscribe.